Good morning. This is Len Childroth from Eastlake in Hopkins, Michigan. I want to welcome you to my daily podcast. Current temperature is about 64 degrees. The high today will be 75. The low is 59. There will be sun and clouds mixed today with a chance of an isolated thunderstorm. And the winds are 5 to 15 miles per hour, I think, this morning. This afternoon, 10 to 15. And tonight, maybe 5 to 10. I'm going to read some more from the Gospel of Luke today. We're going to talk about let the little children come to me. Let the little children come to me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. This I know, for the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me. This I know. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. You are the light of the world, Jesus says. Thank you. I'm going to let it shine. Are you going to let your light shine for Jesus? Another good song that goes along, I think, with our song. We've got a short passage of scripture today from Luke chapter 18. Actually, several accounts about Jesus and children are scattered throughout the Gospels. Jesus raised several, maybe four different children from the grave. They were dead, and then he raised them to life or healed them. Jesus loves children. And when the disciples are going to keep the children from coming to him, he says, "Let the little children come to me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven." Now they were, Luke chapter 18, verses 15 to 17, now they were bringing even infants to him, that he might touch them. And when the disciples saw it, they rebuked them. But Jesus called them to him, saying, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of God. And truly I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a child shall not enter it. Whoever does not receive the children of God like a child shall not enter into it." Jesus has just told the parable of the Pharisee and the tax collector. And the problem that the Pharisee had was that he was proud and self-righteous, and he refused to humble himself. The one thing that is very apparent from the tax collector is who would not even lift his eyes up to heaven was his humility. He was willing to believe in Jesus, and he was willing to humble himself. And so it was the tax collector rather than the Pharisee who went away justified. "Let the little children come to me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven." It's certainly my prayer that children would come to know Jesus Christ. You know, we have a child evangelism fellowship booth at the CEF Fair, and we're there to tell children about the gospel of Jesus Christ. We have Sunday school in our churches because we are concerned about children coming to Jesus Christ. Do you want your child to come to know Jesus Christ, or your grandchild? Bring him to Sunday school. Take him to the fair. Open up the Bible and read to them the gospel. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." God loves children. God loves you. God loves me. And God loves sinners, and God loves children. Father, we thank you for this great message of God's love. God loves the whole world. He even loves sinners and people that are rebellious to him. He loves his enemies, and certainly he loves children. We thank you for the ministries of children that we have in our churches, youth groups, and Sunday school. We pray, God, that you would bless them. We pray you would bless them at First Baptist Church in Otsego. We pray that you would bless those activities at Friendship Bible Church here in Hopkins, and whatever church there is that's preaching the truth. May the truth go forth. We thank you for release time class. We think of Uncle Tim today and his ministry with children at RBM Ministries. We ask for your blessing upon them, and we ask for your blessing upon Vacation Bible Schools. We ask your blessing upon Sunday school. We just pray, Lord, that children might come to know Jesus Christ. We pray, Lord, we thank you, Lord, that if we will believe that God is holy, that men are sinful, if we will believe that our sin is what keeps us from knowing you, and if we will believe that Jesus died on the cross to pay the price for our sins, and if we will believe that in his death and burial and resurrection, Jesus paid the price for all of our sins. And if we will believe in Jesus, and if we will receive him into our life, that you will give us eternal life, and that you will make us one of your children. We thank you that the message is simple. Help us to believe it, I pray today. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, may the Lord bless you, and may the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine down upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you. And may the Lord grant you his peace today.